So I think the best answer is the first two, but not the third. Whether the first could happen depends on what we mean by hijacking a session. So an attacker in the middle could certainly replace this with some other message. Instead of sending the R value selected by the client, sending some other value. And that would make the server pick some different key. And then the message the server sends would be encrypted with that key. That means the attacker could pick an R prime value that the attacker knows and decrypt the messages from the server. It wouldn't allow the attacker to hijack the entire session, though, because the client messages would still be encrypted with K, not known to the attacker based on this R value. And the attacker doesn't have a way to decrypt this, just a way to change the key the server picks. But that's a pretty serious problem if the server is sending messages that the attacker can intercept and decrypt. So this is a problem, and what we'd like to do is change it so the key incorporates more values that couldn't be interfered with by the attacker. We'll talk about how to do that next. First, let me talk about the other answer that's true, that the attacker could easily force the client and server to use a different cipher. So in step two, the server responds with the selected cipher and hash. This is an unencrypted message. An attacker who intercepts it could change these ciphers to something weaker. If the client supports the weaker cipher, the client has no way to know that the server supports a stronger cipher and will settle for the weaker one selected by the attacker. We'll look at how to fix both of these problems next. The challenge is we need to fix them where these steps in the protocol don't have a shared secret yet. We need to agree on the cipher and the hash function before we actually establish the shared key.